What's poppin', guys? You got your coach of the Chim Chargers for our week two GBA team analysis versus the San Francisco Giants, coached by Jim Liturgio, great friend of mine, very solid battler. He has a team of Mew, Mega Scizor, Toxapex, Dugtrio, Ditto, Slurpuff, Chestnut, Haxorus, Blacephalon, Rotom Fan, and an Archeops. This should appear to your right momentarily. This is definitely going to be one of the tougher division matchups due to the fact that his team is very, very solid in my opinion. And I definitely have a lot of preparation in mind versus him, because he has a lot of interesting Pokemon that I definitely have to tweak and prepare for. For instance, Dugtrio is a Pokemon that it can trap a lot of my team, or a good number of my offensive threats like Coco, Incineroar, as well as my like Defogger, which is Empoleon. It can also trap Alolan Raichu, which I did not decide to bring either. Because Dugtrio is like, it's gonna be like something that he's probably gonna rely on with Arena Trap in order to get rid of some of my threats. So I want to make sure that won't happen. Also, he has a Ditto, which can copy a lot of my sweepers. So this week was kind of a little bit tricky to build for, but I definitely think I have a team that can do really well versus him. And I'll show you guys what I got here. So the first Pokemon that I wanted to start off with was Amoongus, and that's actually a Pokemon that I recently acquired. I did mention it in my analysis of my draft for the 11 Pokemon. At the beginning of the season, I told you guys I was going to switch my Hippowdon and Stoutland for Amoongus and Alolan Raichu. I explained reasons there as well. There's another video in the for the GBA channel that explains that trade as well. But Amoongus is going to be super useful in this matchup, and I can show you guys why here. We have Rocky Helmet, but with max HP, max defense, so this thing can actually check a lot of his team. It can provide us a reliable switch into Dugtrio from my Shedshell Pokemon that I have, as well as having Foul Play, which can deal a lot of damage to his physical setup sweepers like Haxorus, Blacephalon, as well as what else? Mega Scizor, SD Mega Scizor, it can check that really well. Dugtrio, of course, like I said, it's going to be able to switch into it really nicely. Really solid regenerator pivot. And it has Clear Smog, so Pokemon such as Bellydrum, Slurpuff, or Chestnut can't really set up on this too well. And what else? I think overall, like, this Pokemon, it's going to be sort of like the backbone holding this team together in terms of, having a lot of good offensive pressure on my team while also having a sort of, sponge that can take hits pretty well that I need to. And I do have Stun Spore on it as well, just so that I can, potential paralysis is always nice. It can really come into handy if I want to paralyze maybe his Mew or something. Even though, like, it's going to probably synchronize back to me, it doesn't really matter too much. As well as maybe what else? Haxorus could be nice. He may have a Lumberry, so I mean, I just want to Foul Play that. And I don't know. I think it's just the last move, I think, is fine. We have a next Pokemon here, which is Incineroar. I wanted to build a sort of... I wanted to bring Dark Spam a little bit, because looking at his team, his only Dark Switch-ins are Slurpuff and Chestnut, both of which kind of don't do too well 1v1 versus Incineroar and Hoopa Unbound. So I wanted to bring these two guys for some Dark Spam this week. We have Incineroar with the Shed Shell, running Shed Shell because, of course, it does get trapped by Dugtrio and it is slower, so having that is nice. Also, if he tries to copy me with Ditto, I can bluff the fact that I'm choice locked by having four attacks, because this thing can run SD, this thing can run any sort of like setup move or anything like that. So we have a lot of mixed defenses here. I wanted to put more in Spidef so that we can take hits better from Blacephalon. This is my main Blacephalon answer, so I felt that this Incineroar was absolutely necessary this week in case he brought it. And with this Spidef, of course, we can take his Z move from Blacephalon really, really well. Like, it does about maybe 30% or something. And I don't know. Like, I just like put a couple EVs here and there in attack defense, just so that we can take hits a bit better from things. And that's pretty much how I EV my things. I think some people have asked, like, you should explain a lot of your EV spreads and stuff. Basically, HP, Spidef, and I just tossed a bunch in random places to make it look cool. That's what I do for all my EV spreads. That's what makes it clean. So yeah, basically Shed Shell, four attacks. Really nice with U-Turn, being able to give us momentum into one of our other threats. Speaking of threat, we have here a Hoopa Unbound with a Focus Sash. Likely, I'm probably going to lead with this versus his team, just because with Sash, I probably get a knockout on something immediately right off the bat, which could be really useful to put him on the back edge of the game, or the back foot of the game. And yeah, I'm running a special set. I think special is better in this scenario just because of because I used to run a shed shell on this set, but I wanted to change it to focus ash just because of how well it does as a lead. And I think he may lead with something that you know, if he does decide to lead with something that can do really well versus Hoopa, we have a sash here, so we can still click an attack like Dark Pulse, for instance, which he has very limited switches to, or maybe try to cripple something with T-Wave. We do have some paralysis here just so that we can make some of our slower threats a bit faster, like Incineroar, for instance. But this Hoopa set is nice. I think I set this thing to be faster than a max speed Mega Scizor if he's running Jolly SD, because actually offensive Mega Scizor is kind of a threat because Incineroar does get blown back by a superpower. In that scenario, Amoongus's Foul Play will come into use. Also, Hoopa's Focus Sash with HP Fire will Oko it, so that's going to be really nice. And those are our first three Pokemon here. I think Focus Sash Hoopa is really, really useful, and it can help us survive a hit and just deal a lot of damage back to another Pokemon. Next, we got our last three Pokemon here. I wanted to bring Tapu Koko because I felt that even though he has a Dugtrio, he's forced to run Scarf in order to be faster than us. I have enough speed here to outrun a Jolly Nature Dugtrio and max special attack with rest and defense here. So I'm running a Combine Roost set. Reason is because this actually beats Ditto 1v1. And it's another reason why I have T-Wave and Stun Spore on Amoongus. Ditto has to run, I guess, a Choice Scarf, right? Because in order for it to be a threat and outrun other threats that set up, it should be faster than them, guaranteed. So that's why if he brings a Ditto, it's going to be Scarfed, more than likely. So we have T-Wave for that. And then we also have a Combine Koko, which actually can set up over Ditto. So even if Ditto copies us, we can still Roost up. And he only has 5 times that he can use each move, whatever he locks himself into. So Shed Shell allows us to switch out of Scarf Dougie. And I think these are the two main Shed Shell Pokemon. I do pack Empoleon here, and I don't have a Shed Shell in it. I have a Shuka Berry. I'll explain that in a second. Next off here, we have Mega Pinsir. So after Tapu Koko, I definitely figured Mega Pinsir is going to be amazing, amazing versus his team, due to the fact that he only has 2 flying resists on his team, that being his Rotom Fan and his Archeops. And I figured that, like, he has to bring one of them. So my thought process is that, okay, I feel like he's going to either bring Archeops or Rotom Fan because he might want a flying resist on his team. So he's probably going to bring one of those Pokemon. I don't think he'll bring both. He could, but I don't think he will. He'd probably want to bring Dougie for sure so that he can try to trap something. And because I feel like the way his team is, right, he's going to try to trap something with Dougie and then try to open up a way for another Pokemon to put in work. So that's why I have, like, the main Pokemon he can trap, he can't. So I have Shed Shell on that so that we can prevent that strategy of his from ever happening. So I think he'll bring Dougie. I think he'll bring either Rotom Fan or Archeops. For sure, I think he'll bring Mega Scizor. I think it's pretty solid versus my team, as well as Ditto. And I kind of want him to bring Toxapex, but I don't know if he will. I'm kind of banking on him bringing Toxapex so that we can just blow it back with our nice and powerful mons. If he doesn't bring that, then he'll definitely bring, like, maybe, I don't know if he'll bring Mew. I have Hoopa Unbound Incineroar, but he can always run some kind of tech on it. I remember Joey tested versus me. He brought, like, X-Scissor, Earthquake, Volt Switch, and something else versus me, and it was kind of annoying. I don't think Gio's gonna bring that, but who knows, okay? Like, he brought that versus me, like, maybe the 4th or 5th time we were testing, just so that he could destroy my team. That's why, the main reason I changed from Shed Shell to Focus Sash, because I just don't want him to have some kind of coverage that will knock me out in one hit. So Focus Sash is going to be really nice in those kinds of scenarios. So we have Pinsir, and the idea behind this Pinsir set is it's an SD3 attack set, right? So you're probably wondering, right? He has a Ditto. Why would I bring an SD set with 3 attacks to this matchup? The reason is because last week I brought Return on it, so I think he'll probably want to set his happiness on his Ditto to max 255 happiness. But if I'm running Frustration, then he's actually going to have a tough time with that, because he's going to copy, he'll have max happiness but frustration, so his damage output is going to be extremely pitiful. So that's another idea I had here. I'm going to bring Frustration, 0 happiness. His Ditto is probably going to be max happiness, and that frustration is going to bounce off, leaving only Quick Attack and Rock Tomb, which is walled by my Empoleon, which, you know, some of my other Pokemon could probably eat up as well. So yeah, that's gonna be really nice. So he can't really counter sweep this set here unless he brings zero happiness, and that's gonna be the mind game from here on out. If we play again, which we do because he's in my division, then it's gonna be like, okay, is he gonna run frustration or is he gonna run return this time with the happiness? So he's gonna have to decide that, should he decide to bring Ditto the next time, that is, if he does bring it the first time. So yeah, I have enough speed here to outrun his Mew, which is the fastest Pokemon that this thing can outrun with Mega form. Maybe I'll put Mega here so that you can get an idea of what it looks like. Pinsir Mega. Maybe I have Moxie ability too for the pre-Mega so that we could probably take something out with a quick attack. But yeah, just an idea here. This thing, it's going to hit really, really hard. And Rock Tomb I have just mainly for like Rotom Fan and Archeops and things like that, just to slow down threats potentially that try to come in versus us. Frustration just knocks out so many different things. It two-hit KOs Scarf Rotom Fan as well, almost. I think it's kind of a roll, but just really solid power. Finally, we have the best defogger in the world, Empoleon. And I have here a nice Stealth Rocks defog, Scald Ice Beam, standard set from what I always usually run, or in this slot, maybe Roar or Toxic or just some like filler move. I have Ice Beam just so that we can hit Haxorus, Chestnut, Rotom Fan, Archeops, things like that. And Shaka Berry instead of Shed Shell, just in case he wants to try to trap this thing early on before trapping Incineroar or Tapu Koko or anything like that. Maybe he can't trap that. Maybe he's like, okay, I'll try Empoleon this time with Shaka Berry so that we can kind of lure the Dugtrio to stay in and try to knock it out with the Scald early on, so we don't have to worry about him potentially knocking off Shed Shell and then trying to trap us, or you know, just anything like that. So that's gonna be the team. Hopefully we can win this week. I'm feeling pretty good about this matchup, I guess, even though his team is really, really good in my opinion. So yeah, we get to see if Hoopa Unbound can put in some work for the first time for its nice debut. Let's see if it can put in work. Incineroar as well. Hopefully these two can get a knockout somewhere. And of course, I think that Mega Pinsir will put in a lot of work in this matchup, and I'm hoping that it does. Of course, while Empoleon proving that it can successfully defog for me in any kind of matchup, even if there are a ton of threats on his team. Overall, I don't think we are missing sort of anything that we are weak to, but let me know what you guys think, of course, and I hope you all enjoyed this builder. Of course, the match is going up tomorrow, 24 hours from whenever this video goes up. I think I have to still confirm with Geo when this video goes up here, but yeah, so hope you all enjoyed, and I will see you guys tomorrow for the battle. Peace.